Hi, it's Lydia Gabel with Compass Real Estate, and we're excited to give you an annual report of how 2017 ended up. We've been giving you quarterly updates throughout 2017, and now it's time to kind of give you where did the year end up in 2017. And overall, as we were saying all year long, it was a good year. Overall, inventory stayed tight. Homes sold. We actually sold about the same number of homes in 2017 as 16. In Conejo Valley, which we talk about, Agora, Thousand Oaks, Westlake Village, and Newberry Park, we sold 2,583 homes in all of Conejo Valley. That's down 1% from 2016. So what is that saying? The number of units sold is basically staying relatively flat. So we're thinking that's the new normal. So inventory is stayed tight throughout 2017, but buyers who wanted to buy were able to get in. What happened to prices? Again, prices stayed relatively flat. We saw 1-2% bump in anything under $1.5 million. The big story was homes over $1.5 million were selling, and that had a nice price increase because we saw more homes selling from 2017 to 2016 that were considered the higher end for the Conejo Valley. But overall, anything under $1.5 million, 1-2% growth, really we call that a pretty flat, stable market. And how we're starting 2018 is we're really light on inventory. It's the same message that we said last year. Overall, there's only 340 homes on the market in Conejo Valley. That's down 4% from last year. I think people were really seeing a slowdown in November and December and saying, you know what, let's take our homes off the market. Let's come back in the springtime because spring is a strong market in the Conejo Valley. So we're starting to see inventory pick up every day, new listings coming on the market. So I think if you're a buyer, be ready, be on the lookout, be working with an agent because we think inventory is going to start increasing, especially after the Super Bowl, like we see it happening all the time. The number of homes in escrow is only 140 homes, so we're down 30% compared to 2017 going into January. So again, inventory is light. What's causing that? So under $500,000, we currently have only 23 homes on the market and 23 are in escrow. So again, 1 month of supply of inventory, anything between $500 and $1 million, we have 129 homes on the market, down 20% in inventory and 81 homes in escrow. So you've got less than a month of supply, but the days on market is starting to take a little bit longer. It's taking 62 days in average days on market. So again, we're starting to see homes stay a little bit longer on the market and buyers being a little choosier in what's happening. Between $1 million and $1.5 million, we actually have more inventory in the market than we did last year. We have 66 homes on the market, which is a 22% increase. So we're gonna watch that $1 million, $1.5 million, because remember, there's only 15% of the sales came from $1 million to $1.5 million in 2017. So this market between $1 million and $1.5 million is starting to increase a little bit in inventory, yet it was only 15% of our market in sales in 2017. So that market, we have to be a little bit more price competitive, we have to stage our homes, and we have to get the marketing even sharper between $1 million, $1.5 million. That's something we're watching in 2018. And over $1.5 million, there's a lot of inventory on the market. There's 124 homes on the market and only 17 in escrow. So a lot of choices, a lot of inventory available. They're going, they're selling, but there's a little bit more inventory on the market. So again, if you're a buyer, you've got good choices. And if you're a seller, it's just gonna take longer. Days on market, 178 days on market for anything over $1.5 million. Okay, prediction. 2018, we had a tax reform, right? There's some tax changes. Everybody's talking about what's going on with taxes. Overall, the $1 million change to $750,000 on your loan, on being able to take your property taxes. So your loan amount got reduced to $750,000. We think relatively that it's going to affect some people, but overall we don't expect the tax basis to change a lot in the housing market. People still want to buy. Rentals are expensive. Rentals are going up. We had the fires in Montecito. We had the floods. There's a lot going on that the rental market pricing is starting to go up, and people still want home ownership. So we'll keep an eye on it, but we still think we're predicting inventory to stay tight. We still think buyers will buy. We think interest rates will see an increase, but not dramatic increase in 2018. And knowing us, you know we're going to be pretty analytical. We'll keep you informed. So if you have any questions, it's a good time to be selling your home. So if you've been in your home a long time and you're wondering where you're going to move to, call us in. We're strategizing. But it's a good time for you to downsize and potentially take your equity and go move somewhere else. Maybe rent for a little bit. Maybe move twice. If not, we can maybe uncover some inventory for you. So we're strategizing with a lot of people. It's a good time to sell. It's a good time to be buying. I think you've got to be working with agents and keep your finger on the pulse. But we'll keep you informed in 2018. We're excited about 2018. We're here to help you. We're here to help you navigate what's going on with the taxes. We're keeping an eye on it for you. We hope it's helpful. Thanks. Talk to you soon.